Now, a bit about the humidity and the oxygen, last few slides. Humidity is very important aspects of ventilation. Without humidity, you should not be ventilating any baby, and you should not be giving non-invasive ventilation without humidity, because it is going to cause significant damage to the delicate epithelium and the alveoli. So what is absolute humidity? The amount of water vapor per liter of gas measured as milligram per liter, and relative humidity is measure of how much water vapor is in the gas compared to the maximum capacity to hold. This is very important for managing CPAP. That's why I put up these slides. So if you look at what is the difference. So in this, at 30 degrees centigrade, if you have 15 milligrams per liter of absolute humidity, this is 50% relative humidity, because this air can hold more water. But when you go up to 30 milligrams per liter of absolute humidity, this at 30 degree gives 100% relative humidity. So as the temperature increases, the amount of air, the amount of water vapor the air can hold goes up. As the temperature drops, the amount of water it can hold significantly comes down. So warming the gas increases maximum capacity to hold water vapor, and cooling the gas reduces capacity to hold the vapor. So this is what is dew point we see regularly. So daytime, the temperature is high, it takes up more water if there is water in the atmosphere. And nighttime, when it starts cooling, it can't hold up all the water because the temperatures drop. Therefore, it forms a dew point. And this is what we see early morning when we walk around. Lot of dew points in these gardens and fields. So gas is fully saturated given temperature when it's 100% relative humidity. Any decrease in temperature, water vapor is lost as condensation. This is what is important while managing CPAP, which I'll tell you later. So here, this is the condensation point. Here, this is an excellent device. Lot of research has been taken care here. When you heat this here, the incoming gas is heated here. Water vapor is here in this chamber. Therefore, the air takes up maximum amount of water vapor. So at 37 degrees centigrade, it has got the maximum amount of water vapor. And further, when it travels in the inspiratory limb, this is further heated up to 40 degrees by the time it reaches. But there is no further water vapor here. So relative humidity, which was 100%, will decrease at this point to around 70 or 80% because the air has been heated, but there is no enough water. Why this has been done? This is with a purpose. Again, when the air travels from this point through the interface to the baby, there is a drop in temperature because there is no heated wire here. So this temperature goes back to 37 degree, and that's where it has got 100% relative humidity, which the nose babies require. So this is the picture showing the different temperature, different areas. So this baby requires 37 degree air with 100% relative humidity. So again, why we should not be using centralized gases, medical gases? The temperature can be generally minus 20 to plus 20 degrees centigrade, which is much lower temperature. Babies require 37 degrees centigrade air. The humidity, relative humidity, is only 2% in medical gases. Baby's lung requires 100%. And medical gas absolute humidity is only 0.3 milligrams per liter, whereas baby requires 44 milligrams per liter to attain the 100% relative humidity. And that is one of the reasons why we should not be using high flow nasal cannula directly from the central lines. So normally in a bigger children or adults, this is what happens. Room air, which is around 22 to 24 degrees centigrade, will be having 35% of relative humidity, gradually goes up. And by the time it reaches lung, it reaches 100% relative humidity. But extreme preterm babies and preterm babies won't have this capacity. So we have to give the required humidity and temperature for these babies. Advantages of this humidity: it reduces the heat and water loss, preserves gas exchange, preserves energy for the growth, improves weight gain, reduces risk of infection, and improves the mucociliary transport system. This is very, very important. This is the, with adequate humidity, all the cilia are maintained and healthy. And if there is poor humidity, within few hours or few days, this is what happens to the important cilia. So similarly, humidity is very important for functioning of each of these epithelial cells, cilia, aqueous layer, and the gel layer. All is very important. I'm going fast because slides are more. I've last few slides. So if the humidity is less, initially there is the maximum clearance level goes down. As the humidity starts coming down, more and more problems starts happening. Initially, the mucus gets thicker, and then further drop in humidity, the clearance level stops. Further drop, the cilia stops functioning. Further drop in humidity, the cell gets damaged and dies. So maintaining humidity in the airways is very important for a proper management of these preterm babies. So how it prevents infection? If you look at the size of the water vapor, they are very tiny. That's only 0.0001 microns. A virus is about 1 to 40 microns. A bacteria is about 0.2 to 10 microns. And water vapor or water droplet is much larger. So this water vapor or droplet can carry both virus and bacteria, whereas this water vapor cannot carry virus or bacteria. Therefore, a humidified air will not generally carry any virus or bacteria along with it, unless the bacteria transfers through the side of the tubings.